1800-11-4000, यही कंज्यूमर हेल्पलाइन।
Welcome to Call You TVI, the only show in the country which puts you, the consumer, ahead of others. Today we are discussing all your mobile phone related problems, call charges, call drops, unwanted value added services. All you need to do is pick up your phone right now and call us. The lines are open now. The number is 022-4098-7300. We also have an SMS number, which is 55995. You can also email us at oncall@qtvi.com. Here on the show, joining me today to answer all your queries in our Mumbai studio, we have Mr. Ochintu Mukherjee, Honorary Joint Secretary, Bombay Telephone Users Association. This is also the body that is recognized by Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. Mr. Mukherjee, welcome on the show. One quick opening comment from you.
Thank you for having me on the show. The lots of issues for consumers in mobile telephones as well as every range of consumer services in this area. And I'm glad that you organize such programs. And I do hope that more people will be asking the queries and being more aggressive about seeking solutions to their problems.
Right, Mr. Ochintu. And we already have our first caller, Mr. Rahil Ghoshal, who is joining us from New Delhi. Rahil, if you can hear me, please go ahead with your query, sir.
Yeah. I just wanted to ask that I have got a prepaid connection in which the initial cost of acquisition was rupees 100, but the talk time was just rupees 10. So do you think, is it justified?
Right, Mr. Ochintu, if you heard his question correctly, is it justified that he bought a prepaid card for 100 bucks or 100 rupees and the call time or the actual amount or the actual talk time that he got was just rupees 10?
It's like this, exactly what was the 90 rupees, other 90 rupees adjusted against? Because normally when you buy a prepaid connection, you are, say for instance, enlisting yourself as a mobile subscriber, and there is an entry charge, which SMS card, etc. But once you've got it, the mobile cards which are given to you have certain talk time. Now, normally the talk time reduction is just about, you know, with the service taxes which are there and issues like that, charges like that. But 90 rupees short appears to be a little too high. And I was wondering which would be the service provider who's doing this.
Mr. Ochintu, let me just interrupt here a bit. Is there any redressal mechanism available for consumers like Rahil to take this to a court of law, maybe to a consumer court, maybe to TRAI?
As it is, TRAI does not look into any individual complaints. What happens is that they have created a three-tier process within the service provider's organization to take care of the problem. The first place, of course, is the customer care center. Now, they are supposed to be coming with a resolution of the issue within 3 days. And just in case they don't do that, then that is the stage of the nodal officer. Now, for all things like disconnection and faults, etc., it's 3 days. But for other issues, particularly billing, it takes about 10 days. Now, one of the biggest problems is that nodal officers and appellate authorities above them, these people are just not available on the telephone. They don't reply to the emails at all. Now, this is a great deficiency in the system. And we have brought this to light repeatedly with the regulator. And there has to be some method by which the service providers are brought under control. But the system basically is this three-tier structure: call center, nodal officer, appellate authority. Each one is given a certain time limit to redress the grievances. Now, if this fails and there is no satisfaction either in the answer that is given or if there is no answer given at all, then you can go to the next stage, which is really taking it straight into a consumer court. Now, with TDSAT, which is the appellate authority which is there in the TRAI Act, they are only for groups of consumers. And there is a great difficulty in doing this because individuals cannot go to the TDSAT easily, particularly if they're not locally based in Delhi or whatever, because that's the only tribunal center that is there established. So what happens then is that you really have to go to the consumer court. Now, this could be either a grievance of, which we are saying the deficiency in the process, in the product or the service, or it is unfair trade practice. Now, all this is laid down in the consumer
right,
court.
Mr. Mukherjee, Mr. Mukherjee, I have to interrupt you here because one of our other callers who is calling us from Punjab is waiting on the line. Mr. Sure. Sunil Kumar, I guess you have been waiting for quite some time. Please go ahead with your query, sir.
Okay, ji, hello.
Yes.
Hello, sir, good evening, ji.
Good evening, Sunil. Go ahead.
Sir, मैं पंजाब से बात कर रहा हूँ, अबोहर शहर से. सुनील है सर मेरा नाम. सर, मैंने स्टार्टिंग में ना एक वोडाफोन कनेक्शन लिया था, तब ये हच के नाम से चल रही थी कंपनी. तो उस टाइम पे सर मैंने पोस्टपेड कनेक्शन लिया और इसको मैं सेटिस्फाई नहीं था तो मैंने प्रीपेड करवाया इसको. बट थोड़े टाइम बाद इनका रिप्रेजेंटेटिव मेरे पास आया, वो बोलता है कि आप इसको पोस्टपेड करवाइए, बड़ी अच्छी फैसिलिटी है और मतलब अच्छे आपको प्लान, अच्छा प्लान देके जाऊंगा मैं. तो मैं बोला ठीक है. तो उसके बाद मैं मतलब काफी मोटे इनको बिल पे करता रहा. तकरीबन ये जो लास्ट 2-3 सालों में मैंने इनको 45 से 50 हजार के बीच में बिल पे कर चुका हूँ. और मैंने इनको कहा कि मेरा सर, मैं अभी फाइनेंशियल कंडीशन मेरी ऐसी है कि मैं मतलब पोस्टपेड नहीं रखना चाहता, तो मेरा पहले तो प्रीपेड कर दीजिए. अगर प्रीपेड नहीं कर सकते तो प्लान डिक्रीज करिए, मैं ये प्लान नहीं लेना चाहता. तो ये कहते हैं कि आप सर हमारे प्लैटिनम कस्टमर हैं, तो हम ना तो आपका प्रीपेड कर सकते हैं और ना हम आपका प्लान जो है वो मतलब कोई और प्लान आपको चेंज करके नहीं दे सकते. तो सर ये प्लैटिनम कस्टमर को तो फंसाने वाली बात हो गई, कोई सुविधा तो ना हुई मेरे लिए प्लैटिनम कस्टमर बनने की. और फिर अगर ना इतना मोटा बिल पे किया हुआ है सर इनको, तो मतलब अगर नहीं प्लान चेंज करते थे, मेरा कम से कम प्रीपेड कर देते. कस्टमर तो हूं ना इनका, मैं कहीं जा नहीं रहा. तो फिर लास्ट मेरा 650 रुपए बिल था मेरा. मैंने इनको कहा कि मेरा प्रीपेड कर दीजिए, मैं बिल अपना पे कर देता हूँ. तो 450-400 के करीब मेरी सिक्योरिटी इनके पास डिपॉजिट थी. तो इन्होंने क्या किया, बिल मेरा मतलब अगला नेक्स्ट जो आता रहा वो रेगुलर चलता रहा. तो मैं बंद करवाने के लिए बोलता रहा, जो मेरे पास बंदा बिल लेने आता था उसको भी बोला मैंने कि सर प्लीज मैं ये नहीं चलाना चाहता हूँ आगे. तो हमेशा यही मतलब मुझे आगे से आंसर आते रहे कि सर प्रीपेड तो ये हो नहीं सकता, इसके अलावा कुछ बोलिए. तो फिर मुझे कहते कि एक सोल्यूशन है कि ये मेल आईडी देता हूँ आपको मैं, तो इन पे आप कॉल कीजिए, मेल कीजिए, आपको कोई ना कोई रिवर्ट आ जाएगा. तो वो जैसे कंप्यूटर बाउंस बैक करता है तो वही मुझे रिवर्ट आता रहा. तो उसके बाद फिर मैंने बिल पे नहीं किया. तो इनके कोई एडवोकेट है, वो मुझे मेरे ब्रदर को फोन करके बोल रहे हैं कि 650 रुपए बिल का 7-8 हजार रुपए बिल पड़ा हुआ, वो आपको देना पड़ेगा. और नहीं देते हो इन बिटवीन आप, तो आपको फाइन लगा के हम तकरीबन 17-18 हजार रुपए आपको पे करने पड़ेंगे सर.
मिस्टर सुनील कुमार, इट सीम्स वी हैव गॉट योर क्वेश्चन. बिफोर वी मूव अहेड, we have here with us Professor Sriram Khanna, who is the chief convener, National Consumer Helpline, who is a regular on this show. We also have Mr. Ochinto Mukherjee joining us from Mumbai. So two big guests or two authorities on this telecom related issues joining us today to answer all your queries. I would like if Professor Sriram Khanna, you could address this issue that Mr. Sunil Kumar is facing.
See, it appears Mr. Sunil Kumar is in touch with the sales representatives of the company. Unka kaam sirf bechna hai and they are to make money, and they will not show him a way where they earn less money from him. He has a right to convert it to prepaid. If they refuse, that refusal is illegal. Number two, he wants to change the plan, they have to change the plan. Whether he's a platinum customer or not, that is an internal matter of the company. The customer can do what he likes. So the best thing he has to do is he should make a complaint in the call center, get a docket number. If they still don't do it, go to the next stage. And
sir, मेरे पास इनकी रिकॉर्डिंग and if, जो you know, मेरे साथ इनकी बात हुई थी कस्टमर केयर पे, तो वो बंदा भी मुझे यही बोल रहा है कि मैं हम सर ये आप नहीं कर सकते, हम प्रीपेड नहीं करेंगे.
नहीं नहीं, तो ऐसा है ना, आप देखो, जो कॉल सेंटर वाला अगर नहीं करता है आपकी प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व, तो आप नोडल ऑफिसर का नंबर लीजिए, उसके वहां दोबारा डॉकेट नंबर लीजिए उसके पास. और वो भी नहीं करता है तो फिर आप उनके अपलेट, तीन अथॉरिटीज हैं, आप नंबर वन पे गए, नंबर दो और तीन पे जाओ आप. और दूसरी बात, अभी कुछ ही दिनों में देखिए नंबर पोर्टेबिलिटी आ जाएगी. नंबर पोर्टेबिलिटी यह है कि कुछ पैसे देके अपने नंबर के मालिक बन जाओ और आप दूसरी कंपनी का कनेक्शन ले लो. तो उनको बोल देना, भैया तुम ये ज्यादा तंग करोगे
तो मैं नंबर ले जाऊंगा तुम्हारा अपने साथ, मैं इसका मालिक हूं नंबर का, तुम नहीं हो मालिक, कानून बन गया है और अगले कुछ हफ्तों में या महीनों में ये आने वाली है फैसिलिटी। इसका मतलब यह अपना नंबर लेके आप वोडाफोन को छोड़ो, आप एयरटेल को या किसी और कंपनी को पकड़ लो और जो आपको प्लान अच्छा लगता है वो लो।
Mr. Khanna, let's also take a view from Mr. Ochinto Mukherjee. Mr. Mukherjee, you have heard about this complaint. It's a very strange kind of a complaint. What do you think can be done in such a case?
I agree that with Mr. Khanna that the first approach that he has to do is to go to the call center, take a docket number, make a complaint, finally go to the nodal officer, and similarly, finally to the appellate authority. Number portability, of course, is a little way still to come. So let's not anticipate that at this moment of time. But he has to follow this. And certainly, if a person wants to change from postpaid to prepaid, he has all the right and nobody can refuse him. And he should pursue it.
On that account, let's take our next caller. Subhashish is online from Delhi, it seems. Subhashish, if you can hear us, please go ahead with your query, sir.
Hi. This is Subhashish this side. I can hear you. A couple of months back, I had a connection. And a couple of months back, there was a plan change which I had done. Now, when I had changed the plan, there was a different charge for that plan. It was, I think, 256 plan that was there on Airtel postpaid. I changed it. They said, okay, fine, your bill would be charged next month for that particular plan. Now, in the next month's bill, they had put my old plan for which they had charged me again. They had charged me for the new plan twice. And then when we approached them, like around, almost I can say around 25 to 30 calls made to the call center, spoken to the supervisor, visited the Airtel, the showrooms. There was no solution at all. Now, what do we do in case of this?
Mr. Mukherjee.
This is a harassment to a customer. I mean, Airtel promises such big things. You don't get their networks half the time. Call drop rates are extremely high. And you just don't get any solution. Customers are supposed to be treated properly. I mean, at the end of the day, we are the people who are paying them.
I agree with you, Mr. Subhashish. Let's first take a reaction from Mr. Ochinto Mukherjee, and then we will come to Professor Sriram Khanna. Mr. Mukherjee?
This is a normal problem with most of the companies. And if I might just once again ask him to specifically say, what is this problem? Is it connectivity? Is it call drops? What is it exactly is the problem?
See,
I didn't get it here.
First problem is that they have been non-responsive to a customer's, the queries that I had regarding my bill plan change.
Okay.
They charged me twice. They charged me twice for the new plan. They charged me once for the old plan. And then they're saying that you have two plans activated on your phone, which you have activated. Now, first of all, two plans cannot be activated on one person's mobile number.
Indeed.
Right. And then they have the nerve to say that, sir, you have to pay fine because of some, you have booked it. And there have been, I tried and I told them that get my call records, trace my call records, because every call is recorded. They said, no, sir, we cannot do it for you. I said, then I'll file a PIL or probably I'll go to the consumer forum. They said, sir, you can do whatever you want. And this happened at least 30, 35 times, 25, 30 times over the phone and, in the Airtel customer care center. Now, then finally they say, okay, fine, sir, we'll waive off 100 rupees. I mean, that does not make sense. It was a small amount. It does not make that much of a difference to a customer who's paying a bill of 3,000. But at the end of the day, there's customer service. There's something called as customer service.
I would agree with you entirely. Unfortunately, the problem is not going to be solved easily unless there is the number portability that comes in and you can switch seamlessly from one service provider to another, because that's only the test of competition and what is the quality of service. But in the meanwhile, really the choice will have to be a consumer court. But do first go through the process of complaining to the call center, to the nodal officer, and to the appellate authority, because if you go to a consumer court without having exhausted the internal possibilities of solution which is there, there will the question will come up in the consumer court as well. But finally, it would have to be taken to the consumer court for all this, certainly.
I will ask Professor Sriram Khanna also to react on that.
See, you be prepared to go for a 1,000 rupee problem to a consumer court. You will end up spending 2 or 3 years of your time and probably many 1,000 rupees. So we are not, I wouldn't advise anybody to go to for a problem for 1,000 rupees to a consumer court. You will end up paying more and the company will still have a lawyer and they will still fight you till the end. So my advice would be to actually go get the docket number from the nodal officer, get the docket number from the appellate body, and if it still doesn't work, I have a suggestion. Please call the National Consumer Helpline. 1-800-114-000 is the toll-free number. Register your complaint and tell them it is a chronic case. You've tried everything, it hasn't worked. And maybe that will help.
Right. On that note, we head into a break now. But a quick reminder, if you have any query related to mobile bills, all you need to do is pick up your phone, call us right now. The lines are open. The number is 022-4098-7300. We also have an SMS number, which is 55995, or you can email us at oncall@utvi.com. We will answer them right here on the show. We have a packed show here. We have two eminent guests answering all your mobile phone related calls. We have Abhilash, who is calling us from the capital now. Abhilash, if you can hear me, please go ahead with your query, sir.
Yeah, my question is related to the network, right? My question is, you know, if I may say, one of the top two network providers in India, and, you know, I have excellent coverage throughout wherever I go within Delhi or outside. But the only hitch is whenever I'm, say, in basements or in lifts, the network suddenly, you know, gives a very tough time. Why does that happen? You know, when we have good infrastructure in place and everything, why does that happen?
Professor Khanna, do you want to answer that?
Yes, you know, we carried out a survey of what particular places. And this was a survey in 4 metro cities, and almost every service provider has a problem in particular locations, basements, lifts, and sometimes, you know, odd geographical places where the signal is being either disrupted because of disturbances between the tower and where the location is. And this you will find with almost every service provider, without fail. And we have seen in places one service provider's signal will reach in one basement and the other service provider signal will not reach in the basement. So this is not a very easy issue. It's a very difficult, complicated issue. And this is a technical issue, which I'm not really equipped to give a solution for. But I would say that if in 9 out of 10 places your network is fine, stay with it, because if you think by changing the service provider you will get a better coverage, maybe you will get 8 out of 10.
Right, Professor Khanna, there is also one more solution to it which is still not present in India. It's called NGN, which is the next generation network. But on that note, we'll take our next caller, who is Manzoor, who is online with us from Bangalore. Manzoor, if you can hear us, please go ahead with your query, sir.
Yeah, good evening, sir. I'm calling from Bangalore. I have a problem.
Yes, sir. We can hear you. Please.
Yeah. See, I've been subscribing to Idea before it was Spice in Bangalore from 10 years. Okay. And my bill used to be about 1,000 to 2,000 rupees. Last month, I went to Colombo, that is Sri Lanka, and from there to Saudi Arabia, 15 days to 16 days total. So I had asked for that international roaming, which they provided.
Roaming.
And, yeah. I didn't make many outgoing calls because I was on a pilgrimage, and I was receiving normal calls. And can you guess what the bill was when I came down? It's 26,000 rupees.
5,000.
26,000.
Yes.
Mr. Manzoor, what's your problem? What's the exact query? If you can sum it up quickly, sir.
That's what I'm saying. We have charged me 26,000 rupees for 15 days. What do I do?
Mr. Mukherjee, who is joining us from Bombay, Mr. Mukherjee, can you please take Manzoor's question, sir? He was made to pay 26,000 is what he's alleging.
Mr. Manzoor, I'm sure you're a postpaid subscriber.
Yeah, from 10 years.
Okay. Now, you have the facility of a detailed itemized billing.
Yeah.
Now, there it is specified by the regulator that the time, the call rate, all of it is to be detailed and shown to you for every call that you made. Now, I would suggest, first of all, that you take the itemized bill, because normally most of the people take itemized bills so that particularly those who are traveling and who have high billing really to pay. So you take an itemized bill and find out whether these rates charged or the timings are not really accurate. Because it's only if there is an inaccuracy in the billing, then the question comes up whether 26,000 is justified or not. So first one has to get into the basic, examining of the issue of the details. And then if you find that there is a problem in spite of that, then you can take it up. But without these details, it's difficult to say whether it was a justified billing or not.
Right, sir, we head into a break now, but a quick reminder, if you have any query related to your mobile bills, all you need to do is pick up your phone, call us. We have two eminent guests joining us from Delhi and Mumbai. The lines are open now. The number is 022-409-8730. We also have an SMS number, 55995. You can email us at oncall@utvi.com and we will answer them right here on the show. Back show this is. We have Ashutosh Bhattacharya who is calling us from New Delhi. Ashutosh, please go ahead with your query.
I actually have a couple of questions. I'll start with the first one. What does DND cover? You know, because I have registered under the DND, but I still get, calls. And more importantly, my question is towards SMSs. How does one stop, these service SMSs, coming to your number?
Ashutosh, we will have to interrupt you here. We will have Professor Sriram Khanna to address what does DND cover?
No, DNC, it's actually not call registry. Once you register there, then the requirement is that every call center operator will have to clean his lists and not call the ones which are listed. And normally it works, but still there will be some small-time operators.
Right, Professor Khanna, it seems we are running late on the show. Let's get a quick reaction from Mr. Ochinto Mukherjee. Now, how does one stop SMSs, unwanted SMSs? Very quickly, sir.
Unfortunately, that's the thing that keeps happening in spite of the fact that you register and some of them continue to do this. And really speaking, unless the regulator looks into this seriously, there's not very much that can be done.
Right, sir. On that note, that's all we have time for now. Call UTVI. We'll be back same time tomorrow with Stay Hungry, where we will be answering all your career-related queries. Stay tuned. Keep learning. Keep watching UTVI.